নমস্কার, আমি অচেনা মণ্ডল। আজকে আমরা ইথুন স্টুডিওতে রেকর্ডিং করলাম ট্র্যাজেডি অফ ওথেলো। আদিত্যদার সাথে আমি তো বেশ কিছু স্মৃতিনাটক করেছি এবং অনেক কাজও করেছি। হঠাৎ করে একদিন টেলিফোনে উনি আমাকে বললেন গুড মর্নিং খুব ভারী গলায়। তারপরে বললেন ওথেলো করবে? আমি তো একদম নেচে উঠলাম, হ্যাঁ ওথেলো করবো মানে কি বলছো? হ্যাঁ করবো, ইংলিশে কিন্তু হ্যাঁ তাই হবে, চেষ্টা তো করি। ব্যাস তারপরে শুরু হয়ে গেল আমাদের অভিযান এবং রোজই আমি মা ফোন করে দাদাকে ডিস্টার্ব করছি, শুরু হলো কাজ, শুরু হলো। কিন্তু এত বড় একটা কাজ সেটা তো খুব সংক্ষেপে শুরু করা যায় না। বইটা কিনতে হবে, তাকে নিয়ে ভাবতে হবে, ঠিক কি অক্লান্ত পরিশ্রম করেছেন দাদা সেটা হয়তোবা আমি কিছু টাচ পেয়েছি স্ক্রিপ্টটা পাওয়ার পরে, কিন্তু আসল কষ্টটা তো উনিই করেছেন। তারপরে আমাদের প্রচুর মঞ্চস্থ হয় ওটা মধুসূদন মঞ্চে, তখন আমরা ওটা মিক্সড ড্রামা হিসেবে নিয়েছিলাম একদম নতুন আঙ্গিকে। শ্রুতিনাটক যেমন স্ক্রিপ্ট নিয়ে বসে পড়লাম স্পিকারের সামনে, সেটা ঠিক ভালো লাগছিল না। ভাবলাম যে আদিত্যদা এবং আমার দুজনকে একই মত হলো যে আমরা ওখান থেকে একটু বেরিয়ে আসি এবং মঞ্চ থেকেও একটু বেরিয়ে এসে দুটো মিলিয়ে যদি একটা কিছু করা যায়। তার নাম দেওয়া হলো মিক্সড ড্রামা এবং মধুসূদন মঞ্চে জয়দীপ দা, কবি কেতকী প্রসাদ এবং আরও কিছু জ্ঞানীগুণী মানুষ ছিলেন যাদের প্রশংসায় আমরা মানে কি বলবো অভিভূত, মানে অভাবনীয় আপ্লুত, আমি কি বলবো আমি বুঝে উঠতে পারছি না, আমি ভীষণ খুশি। তো এই বার্তাটা যাতে সকলের কাছে পৌঁছয় যে ইংলিশেও আমরা কিছু একটু করতে পারি, জানি না হয়তোবা আমাদের অনেক ভুল ত্রুটি থাকতে পারে, এটা তো আমাদের নতুন পরীক্ষামূলক একটা কাজ। তো আপনারা বলুন কেমন লাগছে, অবশ্যই ভুল হলে ভুলটাও বলবেন, ভালো হলে ভালোটাও বলবেন। আর আমি অসংখ্য ধন্যবাদ জানাবো জয়দীপ দাকে, জয়দীপ চট্টোপাধ্যায়, কবি জয়দীপ চট্টোপাধ্যায়কে, কারণ ওনার ভূয়সী প্রশংসা এবং ওনার ইচ্ছায় আজকের এই রেকর্ডিং। নমস্কার।
নমস্কার, আমি আদিত্য দাস। আমরা এইমাত্র রেকর্ড করলাম উইলিয়াম শেক্সপিয়ারের ধ্রুপদী নাটকের নির্বাচিত অংশ ওথেলো। তার থেকে আমরা নির্বাচন করেছি ট্র্যাজেডি অফ ওথেলো। এই অংশটুকু আমরা আগে মঞ্চে অভিনয় করেছি দু একটা শো করার পর, তারপর আমরা শ্রুতিতেও করেছি। আজ এটা রেকর্ড করলাম সেই নির্বাচিত অংশটুকু, সেখানে দেখা হলো ওথেলো আর দেশদীমনার অংশ বিশেষ। সেখানে ওথেলো দেশদীমনার ভালোবাসার সিন থেকে শুরু করে তাকে যে মারা হলো, কেন কি সন্দেহ, সেগুলো আমরা চেষ্টা করেছি আমাদের অভিনয় এবং সংলাপের মাধ্যমে প্রকাশ করতে। এটা আমাদের করার উদ্দেশ্য হলো সোশ্যাল মিডিয়ার মাধ্যমে অনেক মানুষের কাছে এটা যদি পৌঁছে যায় সেই জন্য আমাদের এই প্রয়াস। আপনাদের শুভেচ্ছা আমরা চাই এবং আপনাদের মতামত, মূল্যবান মতামত আমরা পেলে আমরা খুব খুশি হব। নমস্কার।
My dear Othello, look at me. Here I am, your sweetheart.
Oh, Desde, coming, coming. Hi, Desde, my sweetheart. How do you do?
Oh, fine.
It gives me great surprise and delight to find you having arrived to welcome me. Oh, my heart's joy. If I were to die at this moment, it would be the happiest moment for me.
May God forbid such a thing. On the contrary, may your love and joys increase with the passing of time.
May it be so, sweet powers of heaven. I feel such an excess of joy that it is beyond my capacity to describe it at this moment. Let us embrace and our kisses be symbolized the negation of any disharmony between our hearts. My sweet one, people of Cyprus will love you and hold you in great esteem. Oh, my sweet, I am talking of my own joy. Come this day, once more I must say that I am extremely happy to meet you.
My lord, I will be talking about a petitioner who has incurred your displeasure and is now feeling miserable for that reason.
Whom do you mean?
Why, it is your Lieutenant Cassio, my good lord. If I have grace to move you, you should grant his present petition and be reconciled to him. He is the one who truly loves you. And if he has erred, It is only in ignorance and not knowingly. I pray you to decal him, please.
Not now, sweet Desdey. Some other time.
But will you call him shortly?
The sooner, my sweetheart, because it's your wish.
Will you call him tonight at supper time?
No, not tonight.
Tomorrow at dinner time then?
No, tomorrow I shall not dine at home because I have a meeting with the captains at the fort.
Why? Then you may call him tomorrow night or Tuesday morning or at noon or night or on Wednesday morning. Truly, he is repentant and yet his fault is hardly a fault, deserving a personal rebuke from you. When will you call him back? Tell me, Othello.
Oh, Desdey, I pray you speak no more. Let him come when he wants. I will refuse you nothing.
Why? I am not asking you for any great favor.
I will refuse you nothing. I entreat you to grant me a small request. Leave me alone for a while.
Shall I refuse to do so? No. I leave you as you deserve. Farewell, my good lord.
Farewell, Desdey. I will come to you without delay.
What is the matter now, my dear Othello? Your dinner is ready, and the noble citizens of this island, invited by you, are at your presence.
I am to blame for the delay.
Oh, why do you speak in such feeble tones? Are you not well?
I am feeling pain in my forehead here.
Oh, let me bind your head. It will end soon and you will feel relief.
Your handkerchief is too small.
I'm sorry that you are not well. I'll not leave you till you feel better.
I am well, my good lady. Oh, how it is difficult to put on false air. Well, how do you do, Desdey?
I am well, my good lord. I have sent a message to Cassio to come and speak to you.
I have an unpleasant discharge from my nose, which is troubling me. Lend me your handkerchief.
Here, take this, my lord.
Let me have that one, which I had given to you.
I do not have it with me.
No?
No, indeed, my lord.
That's a fault. That handkerchief was given to my mother by an Egyptian sorcerer. She had told my mother that as long as she kept it, she would inspire the love of her husband. At the time of dying, my mother gave it to me and asked me to give it to my wife when luck would favor me with my marriage. Accordingly, I gave it to you. You should be careful to keep it as something very dear and precious to you. Lose it or give away would bring such ruin that no other evil could outweigh it.
Is it possible?
It is true. There is magic in its wave. A Phrocates, who had lived to count 200 years, saved that handkerchief in a state of prophetic inspiration.
Is it true? Indeed?
Most true. Therefore, be careful about its safekeeping.
Then I wish to God that I had not seen it.
What? It is lost? Is it gone? Speak truly. Is it not to be found anywhere?
May heaven bless us.
What do you say?
It is not lost. But what does it matter if it is lost?
Ah.
I say that it is not lost.
Then go and bring it. Let me see it.
Why? I can bring it, my lord. But I'll not do just now. This is a trick. You are planning to divert my attention from the request I have made to you. I pray you to let Cassio be called and arrested at most.
Go and bring that handkerchief. There is a doubt in my mind.
Come. Come, Othello. We'll never find a more capable man than Cassio.
I want the handkerchief.
I pray to talk about Cassio for my sake.
I want the handkerchief.
Cassio is a man. Was ever looked to your love for his welfare and success in life.
Go and bring that handkerchief, otherwise do not appear before me.
Alas, I have never seen him in such a mood before. Surely there is something wonderful in this handkerchief. I am most unhappy to have lost it. my lord. What is your wish, my lord?
Pray, darling, pray.
What is your wish, my good lord?
Let me look into your eyes. Look, look into my face.
What horrible thoughts have you got in mind? Upon my knees, I entreat you to tell me what your words mean. I can perceive a violent anger in your words, but do not understand the meaning of these words.
Why? Who are you?
I am your wife, my lord. Your devoted and faithful wife.
Come, swear it, and by swearing an untruth, damn yourself. You have damned yourself by disloyalty. Now damn yourself doubly by falsely swearing that you are loyal.
Heaven knows truly that I am loyal to you.
Heaven knows truly that you are false like the devil.
False? False to whom, my lord? False with whom? In what way I am false?
Oh, this day, go away, go out of my sight, away.
What an unhappy day is this. Why do you weep? Am I the cause of those tears, my lord? Alas, what sin have I ignorantly committed?
Was this beautiful body, the loveliest figure, created to become a wanton? You want me to tell you what sin you have committed? Adultery. Oh, a public whore, if I wish to narrate your misdeeds, my cheeks would burn like fire, and all modesty would be turned to ashes. Even heaven cannot endure the foul smell of your stinking sin. The moon closes her eyes at the very sight of it. You ask yourself what sin you have committed, a shameless whore?
By heaven, you are doing me great injustice by calling me a whore.
Are you not a whore?
No. By my Christian faith, if to protect this body from being touched by any hateful, foul and unlawful hands, and to preserve it for my husband, is not immoral, then I am not a whore.
What? Are you not a whore?
No. I swear by my hope of salvation.
Is it possible?
Oh God, forgive us.
I beg your pardon then. I mistook you for that cunning Venetian hoe who married Othello. It is the cause. Yes, Desdemona's adultery is the cause, oh my soul, for what I am going to do. Let me not mention it to you, chaste stars. But I shall not kill her by shedding her blood, nor will I stain her skin, which is whiter than snow, and as smooth as a figure cut in alabaster. Yet she must die. Let me put out the light first, and then put out the light of Desdemona's life. If I extinguish this candle, I can delight it. But once I extinguish you, Desdemona, I do not know where will I find that divine fire which can rekindle the flame of life in you. After having plucked a rose, I cannot restore to it the life with which it may grow again. I'll smell the rose while it is still not plucked from the plant. Her breath is so sweet that it prevents the murder. Let me kiss her once more. If you continue to look like this even after death, I shall be forced to love you still this day. Once more I kiss you, and let this be the last time. Nothing so sweet as you was ever so deadly. My sorrow over you is divine, because I am going to kill you while I love you. She wakes.
Who is there?
Yes, Desde.
Will you come to my bed, my lord?
Have you prayed tonight, Desde?
Yes, my lord.
If you can remember any crime which is yet not forgiven by heavenly grace, pray for pardon straight away.
Alas, my lord, what do you mean by such words?
Well, ask for pardon from God. I would not like to kill you if your soul is not yet prepared to leave your body. No, heaven forbid. I would not kill you.
Do you talk about killing?
Yeah, I do.
Then may heaven have mercy on me.
I wholeheartedly join you in that prayer. Be it so.
If you pray for me, I hope you will not kill me. And yet I fear you at this moment. Because you look deadly when your eyes roll in this manner. I do not know. I am afraid. I am truly afraid. I am not out of any guilt. Yet, I am conscious that I am afraid.
Think of your sins.
I am not out of any sins unless it be sinful to love you with all my heart.
You are going to die for that.
The death of a person who is killed for loving it unnatural. Alas, why do you bite your lower lip so much? Some murderous intention shakes your very body.
Be quiet and still.
Now, what is the real issue?
That handkerchief, which I liked so much and had given to you, was given away by you to Cassio.
No! I swear by my life and soul, send for Cassio and ask him if it be so.
Sweet soul, be careful not to tell a falsehood on oath. You are on your deathbed.
Yes, but not yet to die.
Yes, you will die immediately. Therefore, make a confession of your sin without hiding anything. You are to die.
Then be the Lord, have mercy on me.
I say be it so.
And may you have mercy too. I never committed any offense against you in my life. I never gave Cassio a love token.
By heaven, I saw my handkerchief in his hand.
No.
Oh, false woman, you make me kill you with the rage of a murderer. When I thought of sacrificing you for the justice, I saw the handkerchief in his hand with my own eyes.
He must have found it then. I never gave it to him. Send for him here. I let him confess to actual fact.
He has already confessed the fact.
What? What, my lord?
That he...
Yes?
He has used you.
Oh, no. Unlawfully.
Yeah.
He'll not say so.
No, his mouth is stopped.
My fear guides me to understand then. What? Is it it?
Honest Iago has taken measure to stop him.
Alas, he is deceived and I am ruined.
Oh, wanton woman, do you weep for him to my very face?
Oh, my lord, you may banish me, but not kill me.
Down, down you ho!
Kill me tomorrow, let me live tonight.
No, 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 if you resist.
We'll live for just half an hour. Wait only while I see one beer.
No, 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 please, now it is too late. I feel she is no more.
Lord.
Whose voice is this?
Lord.
Not dead? Not yet fully dead? I am cruelly merciful. I would not like to prolong your death pain. Let me end your life thus. What a fool I have been. Before I bid farewell to this world, I just have to say words or two. I have done some service to the states of Venice, and Venetian authorities are aware of it. On one occasion in Aleppo, when a spiteful and determined Turk beat a Venetian and defamed the states, I seized that circumcised dog and stabbed him thus.
Ah.
This day I kissed you before I killed you. The only proper course when I am killing myself is to die kissing you.